Hello, my name is Carol Den Hartog at Amazing Business Results, and today we're going to talk about our roles and profiles inside of Zoho Recruit. So just like in Zoho CRM, Zoho Recruit has roles and profiles, and essentially this is your security system inside of Recruit. So this will determine what your users can see and what they can do inside of the software. So they'll only be able to see the things you want them to see. And on those things that they can see, they'll only be able to take specific action. So for example, they will not be able to delete or export anything out of the system. So let's get into it. The first thing we're going to do is click on the settings icon. And from there, we're going to click on users under users and control. Here, it's going to show us a list of people that are currently using Zoho Recruit. If you wanted to add a new user, you would just click add new user here. Otherwise, we are going to click on security control. From security control, we're going to see we have profiles and we have roles. So the role is going to be what they can see and the profile is going to be what they can do. So the roles are going to be set up. For example, if recruiter admin is the second in line, then they'll be able to see what they create and what anyone under them creates. A hiring manager is only going to see what they create and what the employee creates. They're not gonna see what the recruiter creates. You want to do this if it's necessary in your organization. All organizations work differently. Sometimes you want your recruiters to see each other's data because of the way you operate. Sometimes you don't. So it really depends on how you're operating and if it's necessary or not. So if so, then you would set up a new role. And you would set up a role name. And then under reports to is where you're going to determine where they go. If they're reporting to the recruiter, for example, they'll be able to see everything that everyone's created under the recruiter. So the hiring manager and the employee. Under profiles, this is what they can do. So if we have a profile here, it's going to show us if they can view, if they can create, edit, or delete. So these are the things that we want to keep an eye on. So we would click edit here, and then you could just select the boxes if you want them to be able to do that action. So I recommend going through every single one of these and really paying attention to what people are able to do in the system. And if I were you, I would have delete. I would have none of these checked because you don't want anyone deleting anything inside of the system. And then another thing, we have data sharing settings. So this is going to override the roles in the system. So if the roles are determining that people can only see certain things, the data sharing settings will override that. So for example, if I change departments to public read only, everyone in the company will be able to see all of the departments in the system. Job openings is public read only. So same thing, everyone will be able to see all of the job openings. They may not be able to edit the job opening, but they'll at least be able to see it. So this is a good way if you want people to see one specific module only, this is a good way to do that. And if you're having any trouble getting your Zoho Recruit set up, always feel free to reach out to us at Amazing Business Results and we'll be happy to help.